Jesus. Thank you, Father, for the gift of ministry. Thank you for the richness that is upon my life. Because of your compassion, I've not been consumed. Because of the love, by your mercies, Lord, by your mercies, I'm here. By your presence, I'm still. Oh, give him thanks, give him thanks. He has been reverenced in his love. That's a different love. He has
I step in the gate of my spiritually. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of God. Sana say Rama, Tabakilishaya. And I don't believe to see the goodness of God. I would have fainted long ago. What would I become of me? What would I become of me? What would I be today if I don't believe my God in you? If I don't believe to see the goodness in the living land, to see the goodness in the land of the living world. Thank you for your blessings. Thank you for the fresh anointing. Thank you for the spiritual empowerment every day. It's not by might, it's not by power. It has been the Spirit of God. Receive all the glory. Just give Him praise. Open your heart. Open your mouth. Intentionally tell Him what you feel. Today, just be thankful to Him. Today, lift everything in. That's what the Word of God commands us to do. In Ecclesiastes, that through all circumstances, in all circumstances, let us just give thanks to the Lord. In doing that, it is His will. And as we do His will, He's bringing us back to the Makariya Bush. We line up our destinies with His plan. He will bring us back to that plan. Oh, my God. Particularly that He created you for. That's all you need, child of God. If you can discover that purpose, if you can receive grace today to connect you to that gate, you will break through and you will go through. Or if you can just be sincere in your heart and pray and ask Him, everywhere I've been astray, where I've been led astray, where I've not believed in you, today I come and let it be to you. I connect to His plan. Lead me to the path of life. Lead me to that purpose. Lead me to that plan, Lord. You set me apart. You set it into your mind. For this simple purpose, I will stay in Him. For this simple purpose, I am kept in Him. For this simple purpose, He understands the purpose. He understands it. He said, just worship me. Lord, we are worshiping you. Lord, today, we are free worshipers. We refuse to be bound. Yes, we are free worshipers. We believe in your promises. We believe in your word. Jeremiah, I am like you. You said it is in your purpose. We need a fresh worship that you just told you. If you can deliver us from every bondage, my Lord, we decree and declare that we are the free worship. Now everything that I've bound you, everything that I've been confusing you, every power that has controlled you, every power that has hindered you not to become that free worship, we release the fire of judgment on it. And we set them under arrest. We set that they are under arrest. Today you are free. In Jesus' name. Every spirit of
As you purposely plan, Lord, we become because we believe in you.
we believe in your report. As you purposely planned it for us, Lord, we become. In the name of Jesus, as you call us, Lord, we say yes. As you call us to your name, we say yes to your name. We say yes to your will. We say yes to your will. Lord, we choose today to be part of what you're doing, Lord. We ask in Jesus' name. We choose to wear your robe. We choose to follow you. We choose to serve you. Over every master. We see all the glory. We see all the glory of Jesus. We are grateful, our Father. We are saying thank you, Lord. We are saying thank you. Your presence is intense in this place. We are grateful, Lord. We are grateful, Lord, for your commitment, for being committed to us, for being committed and give us your ear, answering our prayers. Had it not been you, where would we be? Our enemies would have gashed us with their teeth. But blessed be the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Let us appreciate.
can worship him. They can come and worship him. I pray that your heart will be filled. Dry in Jesus' mighty name. The fountains of revelation, I pray that will begin to overflow inside of you. In Jesus' mighty name. You look amazing. You look good. Praise the Lord. Especially worship team.
Worship team.
I don't know what happened at the beginning. You made your stage there. That stage, I corrupt you today in Jesus' name. I fire it. I don't want to see you there. Be where you're supposed to be standing. Give God the glory. You are very smart. We bless the Lord. We bless Holy Spirit for what He's doing in the midst of us. In Jesus' mighty name.
Thank you for coming.
Glory to God. This is a Sunday like not any other. This is a Sunday where a woman is being celebrated.
It's a church of Israel.
The glory of God for my mother.
Not every woman that qualifies to be a mother.
But I want to celebrate every woman because I believe there is a sin inside of you that can never die. Being a mother does not mean only to produce children. There is only you pray in the kingdom of God. As long as you put yourself in the shape of a mother, glory to God. You might be crying today and you think, oh, I have not received the fruit of my womb. But they are those who received it and they had capacity and all the energy to go and bury their own children. They throw them in the pit latrines. They throw them in the streets where they don't even know. So as for you have a heart of the children, you glorify you and your mother. You bless the Lord for your life. For you. Men in the house, can you really clap hands for the women? Lost a mother, God immediately from that day He replaced.
When you feel mama can't
Without you knowing, but God prepared ahead of time, and He knew when that was a mother you need to connect to. We have the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. Glory to God. The love of a mother is the greatest love. It's a love of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because God, because a mother is like a flower, it's something that must be loved. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To challenge you, you've not been communicating to your mother, you've not been really sending messages, at least today make her special. And I stand here in Jesus' mighty name. It's a great day to praise the Lord. It's very important to know that people celebrate you when you're still alive. I don't like people who bring flowers on my grave when you never appeared when I was alive with a flower. If you want to give me flowers, give them today. Yeah. If you want to speak all the affirmation words, give them to me today. All the affirmation words of love. If you really want in your heart to understand that I want to express my love, tell me today. I will take it and I will understand it. Praise the Lord. Instead of crying fake tears, crocodile tears on my dead body. When you never showed me that love when I was still with you. So today, in the absence of Apostle Roger, our professor, I really want to say that we celebrate him in his birthday. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So we want to take this moment just to say happy birthday, man of God. Happy birthday, servant of God. We love you. We cherish you. And we are grateful for all your dedication and commitment and love and services you offer to us. And we pray that on this special day in your life, that just comes once in a year, God will just do a wonderful things you've never met, you've never experienced, what you've not seen, what you've not touched, what you've not heard. Those are all the wishes we have for you in your world. And we pray that you're going to be blessed beyond your imagination in this new year of favor that God added unto you. Hallelujah. Just wanted to say happy birthday. It is one of the jails of the kingdom, and the time of manifestation has arrived. So we cannot take it lightly that we have shared in all the wisdom and the packages God has packed in you. It's a phrase given to give us all that is inside of Him. We are grateful. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody give thanks to the Lord. Thank you and we bless your holy name. Thank you, Holy Spirit. All you need as you come to pray with understanding. If God wants to bless a man, we'll send a man. If God remembers a man, He will bless you, you will send a man. Praise the Lord. Praise the name of the living God. So when we pray, let's pray with the understanding that, Lord, you're going to disconnect me in this month of May and connect me with the right people. it is a blessing when you meet someone who adds something in your life. That will be your prayer. In Jesus' mighty name. And I'm grateful as I stand here before His saints. I don't take it lightly. I give thanks to the Lord every day because I know it's not by might, it's not by power, but by His Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I believe in my intercessions and my givings and my sacrifices are not in vain in your life. To raise the Lord. But always put that microphone on the table in case one's microphone is not clear, then it can be of you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Father, I declare this new day as my day of joy and strength in the Lord in Jesus' name. You can repeat it with me. We will come to pray. Father, I declare this new day as my day of my joy and strength in the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. Praise the Lord. Father, through confidence in your will and integrity, I receive answers to the prayers offered this day on this altar. The Bible says we should approach the throne of God with confidence. So we access the throne today with confidence. Praise the Lord. And we must believe that all we have prayed are answered. That's why he said that even now you have not asked anything. In John 16:24, but ask. And it shall be given unto you. Praise the Lord. Then he reminds us of in John 15 how he has chosen us. We have not chosen ourselves. But he said, I have chosen you. I have ordained you. I have blessed you. And first we go and bear fruit. Living God. Oh God, you are my God. in a dry and weary land where no water is. Hallelujah. I pray that there is nothing is going to take our love. But today, we are going to turn our love to God. Praise the Lord, you have a great Luganda.
They
We are counting 15 minutes just in the presence of God. 15 minutes passed by the exact power maybe you're used to get the service. And the coming out of this, you see them living and very disturbed. They cannot sit under the presence of God. They cannot sit and give God just 1 hour. They cannot sit and give God just 1 hour. Congregation, all the people that were gathered on that day to witness that day. Mama, I can never forget that. Even my uncles, they kept repeating that same word. Go and love your husband. And be careful with his food. It's like, take care of him. And every time he's followed, don't repeat, like, you don't need to in our native language, they were like, hallelujah. Like, you put water in your mouth when the husband is speaking to you. What was that trying to mean in my life? She was trying to say, I must submit. And I must put my passion, all my love, to this man. They are handing me to him today. They are giving me officially to him. So I was willing to do that, that every time, whether he's wrong or right. When the man is telling you something, make sure you put water in your mouth. You can imagine if I put all the passion in man. Just like submit and I love. But I turned my love to God. Be submissive. Love him. Praise the Lord. Obey. That's what the Bible commands us to do. The husbands should love us as the church loves, as Christ loves the church. Do you hear how things follow? And Christ loves the church. You two husbands, you should love your wives. Then as wives we submit. So it's very important to submit. When we know who we are, that the love of our husbands is submitting to. In the two way to come. Hallelujah. Where the love of our husband is turned to. Oh, we're gonna go to the world. We praise the name of the living God. I pray that you will turn your passion to your God. That is what is the prayer. Keep you in the glory. Turn your passion above everything you desire. As I was studying and making this sermon, as I was sitting last night praying for you, my sister can be my witness. She went to bed around 1, and I did not sleep. It's the same as praying and in the city. So I take the egg and raise the name of the Lord. We become what we believe. When we believe that Jesus Christ died for us, believing that God is the restorer, it begins with what I believe. And the moment I believe that restoration was placed upon my life, it will begin to go ahead of me and restore all that enemy took away from me. I sat down, then told her, and I just silenced in a few minutes. Then she said, I don't know, and what came? Praise the name of the living God. Let's remain in the seeking place. It was too detailed. That all we desire, all we have ever wanted, we can only turn. And I remember the Holy Spirit reminded me how people have kept dropping off, how people have sold out their faith. And these are the days that were prophesied ahead of time. When we read in the book of Timothy, 2 Timothy chapter 3 and chapter 4, the Bible says that then the people, they will sell out their faith.
Let's go.
In that name you gave us even before
Praise the name of the living God. But this is the year.
because I told you that I'm going ahead of him.
I'm going to speak.
SACIA. Praise the Lord. I remember in 2008, I was going through a challenge. And I prayed. My life has always been in mountains and seeking His face. There is no English God I will serve apart from this God of Israel. He has proven Himself to me enough. He has come for me in many times. When I don't even know what to do, He shows up. Praise the Lord. 2009, 2010, when He took me to London, I didn't know what to say. I didn't know the language to use, but He gave me the message. Praise the name of the living God. I'm going to host you only 4 days. It has never happened in our family. No one has ever boarded a plane. On top of that, the plane is going where? United Kingdom. Praise the Lord. Ask me if I had an auntie, a sister, brother in the United Kingdom. I didn't know anybody in London. But the
to be the king.
I am a teenager,
but I know the God.
step in this house, and people come, they're like, oh, wow, what happened before? I'm going to allow you to come and visit us.
They paid the
ticket.
They want to see a ticket.
They took me.
They went to
my hosts were all public and shocked and
once
upon this woman is the name of the living God. This one took
you
to the prince
and
I stayed.
The prince
took me to other countries. And they paid a ticket. The last trip I made going to
Sunderland,
that one shocked them. That one pulled them. They said we don't understand this. At least Manchester is understandable.
At least Manchester.
Newcastle is well.
Newcastle so much.
Sunderland.
Yes, Sunderland.
It's like here in when in like us in Angola. Praise God. When we grew up hearing like in Chodera abantu barya abantu wari abasezi.
We had like in Chodera people eat.
You had those stories? In Masaka. Now we not abakoko guru.
And you're like,
praise God.
People from
we are born again, we are free, we are no longer in culture and all these things. Praise God.
You see, so
recently, light up a trolley. I was in that meeting, I thank God, we repented. We back in Angkoli.
Hallelujah.
It was led by patience, and even tomorrow we are going to Maranga. We are going to Angkoli. Glory to God. So we repented, and I was leading that intercession. I saw men falling down. I saw sons of men falling down. Bishops and reverends repenting.
But bishop,
when mercy comes upon you, when mercy and remembrance, you will remember. Praise God.
So hearing you that you are going to guru,
from Sunderland, you cross and go to Scotland.
Go over Sunderland. There is no
place.
There is no
place. Never have you ever been there. I've never
been there.
Never have you ever been
there.
And they told me,
you want to die.
You don't have even money.
I knew my covenant.
I
knew
what I received from the civic place. I knew the words I had when he was replying. As you ask, I am going to grant it to you. As you've asked me, I've granted it to you.
Anywhere you want to go, I am going to take you.
I am going to provide for you. I have seen that. I have seen favor. Isaiah 6 prophesied over you today. In the mighty name of Jesus, that the Gentiles will come to your life. I prophesy it over your life. As long as you carry this light, in the name of Jesus, 61 verse 3. It doesn't matter the darkness that is going to hover the world, but the carrier of the light, as long as we have this light, the ring is the connector. All the kings and the Gentiles will
be
your, and you will be fed on the milk of the nations.
And
prophesy that grace to come upon this
country.
I traveled, I went to Sunderland. It was the best state
God.
People showed me love. They never wanted even to think that I come back.
The
extent someone is like, I'm giving you the whole world, just, but there was no way I'm going to carry those
things. I met pastors, they had a church. Because me, I'm a church girl, I can't be in a place.
Yes.
I asked them, where is the church? The people was asking, they didn't even know, they didn't understand. But because of the light I'm carrying, they had to come with me. They said, oh, we are going to take you to the church. When we reached in that church, the pastors, that's where they love.
We had to come and
they said, stay here, we are going to do whatever it takes. You are the ministry of God, stay here. After service, they took me and the Nigerians. In the service, they went in
the man and
the walls are waiting.
Praise the Lord.
They took me to the supermarket and they said, pick whatever you want.
They want to ask
you,
you
have children. I said, yes, by that time I have two daughters.
They want to go there to eat now.
They said, if you want, you can do business there.
Business.
Another Russian man gave me a full house, everything in the house.
So Russian man gave me to your
paying everything. And I tried to make calls. These people at Katwe, they can't read to start a tour. And they still even
have the Lord.
By then, Moronia Chita Chiri original to Saka Katwe. Second, as many of the shipping are
those days,
I want to prophesy over your life. If you bring back your passion, you are going to go beyond the borders. You are going to prosper. You will be where others cannot be. You are going to see what others cannot see. May you receive that grace today. Connect to come out of the train. Then I was like, how can I go? He was, you took beautiful to carry these luggages. There is a call of God upon your life. To remain in a safe place. He cannot spoke with saying, I'm carrying the things.
He took me up to the edge without using Google Maps, without using anything. The Holy Spirit is our navigator.
Is going to navigate your destiny.
May the Holy Spirit come upon you. Every challenge and every worry. I cannot testify all, but we have seen God. I want you to bring back your passion. Put it back to God.
I was pulling my suitcase. I was just holding my times.
And
in my spirit, I was just worshiping God. I was praising God for the light that has come in the land of children. And it was my first time in that city. I was grateful. I was more worried of her because I trusted fully that He who brought me is going to take care of me. By the time, if He had not wanted me to go, He wouldn't have. God will never take you where His grace will not sustain you. You need faith. You need to be sure that your passion, your love is on you. And the woman was trying to pull my suitcases from her room. From her suit. She said, wait a minute. First pray for me.
So
praise God. I said, okay. I said, God, immediately I spoke to her spirit. I said something that made her scream. How did you know that? I said, God, you know what you're
going
through. I am a servant of God. That's why you honored me and humbled yourself. When we sit, we find. When we ask, we receive. She had not told me to pray for her. I am proud enough because I know what I carry. I don't beg people for what I have. It takes a spiritual eye to see. When she said that, I spoke to her life. Immediately, provision. This room, I mean, let me get another one, stay in this one. We serve a living God. On top of that, so not only I'm not going to pay your water, but I'm going to make sure you eat well, you drink well. And if you don't like the bed, let me call the reception now. They give you the room you like. I
moved
my chair. Rooms, I said I prefer the one you gave me the first time. Let us turn our passion back to God. Anything God is doing, join Him to do it. It's called success. Then you will walk God's glory. Stamping on some. Every ground you stamp on, every ground you step on, I prophesy over your life that you stamp there, you step there, you stamp on it with the glory of God. May you walk in this us. May you walk into that business which has been torturing you. This time you're going to enter your shop. You step into your shop. You are stamping there with the glory of God.
Peace.
Of God.
You cannot
your timing God. Don't listen to that voice that is putting you down.
Don't listen to
that that is accusing you, every accusation of the devil is under arrest today. As for you, you receive mercy in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the name of the living God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. As we turn our passion back to God, we'll be able to take the kingdom by violence. And the Bible tells us in Matthew 12:11 that from the John Baptism, the kingdom of God is taken by violence. So you cannot say like Jeremiah, I cannot speak. Rise up and receive power. When he accepted, when you read verse 10, in the same chapter we have just read, verse 10, praise God, then you will see what Jeremiah was able to become. I prophesy it over your life today. May that grace rest upon your head. May that grace rest upon your head. You're going to uplift and tear down. You're going to fight and conquer. You're going to demolish and build. In Jesus' mighty name, you're going to prophesy over your situation. You will not die prematurely. As you take Holy Communion today, you cannot be bound anymore. You are a free worshiper. You cannot be bound by demons. You cannot be limited by generation curses. You cannot be hindered by generation curses. You have been set apart by the hand of God. You have been set apart by the word of God, spoken by the Lord your creator. May the power come upon you. Empowerment of the Holy Spirit. The spiritual empowerment. As we take the blood, as we take the body of Christ, as we drink the blood, we will remember we have been given power. We have been given power. We cannot accommodate any disease. By His wounds we are healed. By His stripes we are healed. We have been ransomed by the blood. We are forgiven. Praise the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. If the life of a fresh is in the blood, the life of a believer is in Christ Jesus. Leviticus 11:17. That's why it says that if the life of a fresh is in the blood, the life of a church is in Christ Jesus. You cannot be outside Christ. And expect to become anything. You cannot be outside Christ. Don't you expect the greatness? When we go where He has sent us, we are progressing. So take authority to every stagnation, every hindrance, everything that I've been projecting against your progress, everything that I've been standing between you and your victory. That Jericho is corrupting down today. That fear is leaving you. That power is vanishing right now. That the power of God is coming upon you. In Jesus' mighty name, the Spirit of God is coming upon you. You are going to be healed. You are becoming a child of His word. You are becoming great. You are becoming great. You are becoming a solution to your family. You are the one to deliver them. Praise the Lord. Prophesy over your life. Spiritual empowerment. All giftings inside of you. To begin to function perfectly. In Jesus' mighty name. Death has no power over you. Poverty has no power over you. As you draw, as you come, on communion with Him, you are fresh. Is becoming alive. Your spirit is going to live. Your flesh that has been rotten is by pests and all that whatever. Eaten by all evil. Eaten by evil pests. Today you are becoming alive. Today you are going to be well. Today I speak wellness. Today I speak healing over your life. In Jesus' mighty name. yes, every pain is going to go. If he can defeat and shift cancer from a body, from flesh, is able to do exceedingly. If he can remove AIDS that has been spread all over your body, if he can fix the liver that has been failing, every spirit of paralysis, every spirit of preparation is under rest. Whatever has been preparing, whatever has been paralyzing your finances, whatever has brought preparation in every area of your life, I release the fire of judgment. In the gifts of God. We know you can do in the power of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God is doing a new thing. I don't go to teach him. The Spirit of God is raising an army. Your voice purse is going to be heard. Your generation is going to hear your voice. I prophesy over your life. I prophesy over your life. Your life is becoming a wonder. Your life is becoming a miracle. Your generation must hear your voice. He's feeding you. He's dressing you. Don't get out of the room and until you are filled. Don't get out of the room until you are filled. Until you feel. Yes, I've seen him. He's feeding your cup. He's feeding your mind. Somebody bless the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is here. The Holy Spirit is here. Wicked dreams are coming to an end. The wicked dreams are coming to an end. May the Spirit of God fill you. May the Spirit of God fill you until you overflow. Your life is being transformed because the season of transformation has arrived. It is your season. It is your time. In Jesus' mighty name, I feel it, heaven in my spirit. Whatever tried to divert what was for you, it is broken right now. It is broken never again. Receive the power. Receive the power of the Holy Spirit from your berries, or from your feet to the crown of your head. Receive the grace in Jesus' mighty name. The grace that sustains me in the place of seeking. The grace that stayed with the disciples. That grace is the rest in your life. The Spirit of God is here transforming lives. Join forces with your vision. It's your vision for years. The vision for Kansanga. I am available. I am available, Lord. The vision you have for Kansanga. Use me. I'm available for you. I'm available for you. I'm available for you, Lord. The vision you have for the years. The Jerusalem, for the Samaria and the Judea, I'm available to be the witness. You can pray that prayer with me, because God is looking for you right now. He's looking for someone to button with and use. If you can say, I'm available, use me. You are becoming great women. You are becoming great men. In the entire family, he has chosen you. He's choosing you. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. You told me I have called you to raise the true intercessor, to raise the true army. In the last days, the great army. I was in the mountains, I did not know. But God, your army is here. The spirit that came to the dry bones, the spirit that was on Ezekiel, my God, in the valley of the dry bones appear. Yes, you are here. You are here to transform the bones to the great army. You are here to transform the dry bones to the fresh great army of the Lord. I give you praise, my Lord. You are doing it. You started with us. We look like dry bones. But today we have muscle, we have fresh on us. May that spirit that hovered in the valley of dry bones, that hovered Ezekiel, that came upon Ezekiel, I release it. I pray that it will rest upon you. It will rest upon you. It will rest upon you. Make you what it wants you to become. In Jesus' mighty name. I cannot speak among the young. Oh, Jesus, help us. Jesus, help us, Lord. The offices you've entrusted with us, we have neglected them because the flesh is not yet dead. We crucify flesh as you live, as you increase, as you increase in our spirit of God, as the grace increase. May the flesh be crucified. As we take your flesh today, we receive your flesh. We live in your body, Christ Jesus. We eat your body so that we may reflect your life. We may look like you. We cannot do maybe. We cannot be exactly in your compression. But we want to reflect of your deeds, Lord. We want to walk like you. As we take, as we drink your blood. The blood you shed on Calvary, every negativity that has been speaking of here, every poverty, every disease, every power, you send it over. The prison of hope, you are set free. You are set free. When you said, Jeremiah, rise and go and speak as I command you. It is a great army that is arising. That he's able to speak, that he's able to worship, that he's able to shout it louder, that he's able to say it until they hear it. Oh, we are not going to keep you quiet, Lord, until Jesus you're magnified in this city, until you're magnified in our families, until you are seen and accepted, Lord. Oh, contrary, every time, hallelujah, every time that's the spirit, every contrary, every time that every power from danger, from danger. Oh, Every power, somebody you be on the stage of danger, but the grace, is coming upon you, and you are set free in Jesus' name. Oh, we are the prisoners of hope. Let the blood, that the peace of the world, that was shed on the river, to pieces. And I've been kept in bondage, and I've been in captivity for so long. Today, let them find a way. In this month of May, Father, we choose to take the battle back to its gate. As we get out of every battle, as we get out of every danger, my God, every danger zone where we have been tied, where we have been, my God, where we've been in captive, our finances, our joy, our hope. Let there be a release today. Today in the name of Jesus, we declare we take free, my God, of our joy, of our happiness. As we take Holy Communion, we remember, knowing that you said, as you eat, as you take, my God, this is a remembrance of me. This is a remembrance. Ignite our passion to you, Lord, our Creator. Let the laziness, Lord, that is in our body. Let it for wickedness, Lord. Expose and consume every evil altar. As we become free worshippers, as we are set free, as we become free, you are in the room, Jesus. You are in the room. Jesus is in the room. Jesus is in the room. He's going to help us. He's going to help you. He has chosen you. He has ordained you. He's taking you with the pay. He's taking you with the pay. Sit come here. You are the call. Oh, Shalababu, and there is a new grace that is coming upon you. Receive fresh anointing, fresh anointing, fresh anointing upon you. Come on, Holy Ghost. Lord, every confusion is leaving him. Every covenant, Lord, every connection, every association is being lifted up. Yes, you are empowering him. We use your spiritual power. Because we've already sent him a bite. We've already chosen him. You've sent him. Touch his mouth. Touch my God. Touch my Lord. Touch, Lord. Increase him. Let every negativity, every noise be silenced. As you may raise a dick. And take this sword and take power over every evil spirit against your progress, against your spiritual life. Right now, I set them on fire. Let them be arrested. Let them be arrested. As for you, you are free in Jesus' name. You are free in Jesus' name. May wisdom increase. May strength increase. The power of the Holy Ghost. The reign of the Spirit.
From glory to glory.
You are increasing from power to power, from strength to strength. Shame will never see you. Reproach is not your portion. Perhaps during the day and night, they will not fall upon you. You will only see the defeat of the wicked one. Arise and shine. The glory has come. It is your season. It is your time. The set time to favor you. It is up. Jesus, you're here. Somebody. Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, we give you praise. Oh, music. Oh, shake it ever in the sea. I talk about rivers, the rivers of life shall overflow. May the rivers begin to flow. May the fountains of life begin to flow. May the fountains of the blessing inside of you, the fountains of his blessings, the fountain of his favor begin to overflow. Begin to flow. As you take this Holy Communion, I want you to rejoice. I want you to celebrate, knowing that I've been forgiven. Hallelujah. I receive mercy. I have access to the throne. Whatever has been dissevering, whatever has been speaking negativity, let it go. That one is dropping down as you draw near. Every confusion, arguments, foolish arguments of the world, they are dropping down. Choose to seek wisdom. Choose to acquire knowledge. Choose to draw near to him. Choose to be sustained in the place of seeking his face. As his face shine upon you, and as you, oh, Father, you are granting us your encounters today. In Jesus' mighty name. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Did you read that verse I said in Zechariah 9:11 as we come closer? I think Holy Communion story time. Sometimes I just came by just one fact, we are done. But when we allow him to use us, we have no any other choice, because we have already surrendered to be the vessel for him and to do whatever he wants with us in the times he wants. Praise the name of the living God. I believe somebody you're blessed. Is it when we want somebody you're progressing? In Jesus' mighty name. We need his wisdom to God. Hallelujah. As we come across, hallelujah. If you've reached, you can read that verse in Uganda. And reading John 12, verse 21 to 22. Pray, Lord. Paid a visit to Philip, who was from Bethesda, Galilee. They said, sir, we want to meet Jesus. May you meet Jesus today in Jesus' voice. So this came to Philip, hallelujah, who was from Bethesda in Galilee, and asked him, sir, we wish to see Jesus. Hallelujah. Do you know why they were asking Philip? They were bright enough, and it was Philip to guide them and lead them to where Jesus was. Oh, glory to God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Father, through confidence in your will and integrity, we receive answers to the prayers offered today. As we receive this Holy Communion, as we are the partakers of the Holy Communion with you, we believe we have seen you, Lord. Somebody is seeing Jesus today. As you leave this place, you're going to see Jesus. As you are leaving this place, I pray that your eyes will be open and you will see Jesus. I pray that you meet Jesus as you come to take the Holy Communion. In Jesus' mighty name, you meet Jesus. I pray that you see Jesus. It's my prayer. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So, my Philip, Zachariah,
with the era naawe olw'obusaayi obw'endagaano yo zijje abasibe bo mu bunnya omutali
masi. Aleluya! Nga tusembera olw'omusaayi obw'endagaano ya Katonda. Buli musibe yenna sitaani gw'abadde amaze okusaayi omusakuta akusindike mu bunnya obutalimu amazi. Obunnya obutalimu amazi obumanyi ye magombe. Aleluya! Bikuba ne bwetonye etya teritukka gye bakuziika.
Praise the Lord.
You are not going to live.
Praise the name of the living God.
Chico, abasibe abalina esubi ku lunaku lwaleero mbuulira nti ndikutizaawo emirundi ebiri.
Hallelujah. As for you also, because of the blood of my covenant with you, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. May you be free in Jesus' name.
I come
against every projection of the enemy. They are under arrest. All the projections that are against your destiny, against your hope, against your joy. We are defeated today. We declare defeat. We declare defeat. They are defeated in Jesus' name. As for you, you are free. And you are not only going to be free. Praise the Lord. Come back to the place of safety, all you prisoners who still have hope. I promise this very day that you will pay two blessings for each of your trouble. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. Today I declare that I will restore to you double.
May you receive double.
May you receive double. Somebody distribute the Holy Communion. May you receive trouble in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the name of the living God. As we take, we are the partakers of the divine health. Begin to prophesy as I take fresh this body of Christ. I am the partaker of the divine health. I am the partaker of the supernatural power. I am the partaker of divine wisdom. You are free to come. As you speak and say that today I receive mercy in the name of Jesus, and I receive double. Receive double of your peace. Receive double of your joy. Receive double of your peace. Receive double of your happiness. Receive double of your prosperity in the mighty name of Jesus.
Your name is going to go
ever. Your voice is that garden that is watered by
you.
May your life reflect to that. May your life become like that well watered garden by God.
Yes,
Jesus, my name. May your life become Deuteronomy 28. I prophesy over your life. You will eat the good fruits of the land. Deuteronomy 28. As you promised us, may your life reflect to that. As we are the partakers of the supernatural power, we are the partakers of the divine health, we are the partakers of the divine wisdom, we are the partakers of the divine favor. Yes, 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 we connect to my Lord. We drink in remembrance of knowing that in the covenant of his blood, we have been set free. We are free. We are free. We are free. You are free in Jesus' name. You are free from that cancer. You are free from every limitation. You are free from rejection. You are free from any attack of the enemy. You are free. The one that stands set free is free indeed. Jesus.
Abantu
bonna ne bagamba Alleluia. Omusaayi gwa Yesu gumala. As you get your offering and your tithe, in the name of Jesus, I give to the Lord. Give the thanks to the Lord. I speak in praise. I speak in the way of the Sayyidah. As Zachariah and I spoke, I was already Jesus' mighty name. Yes, Lord. You're going to receive the Lord. And the life of death is coming to an end. And the life of struggle and strife is broken in Jesus' mighty name. Stagnation is broken. Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Oh, bless the name of the living God. Give thanks to the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name.
I speak that may God be gracious to you.
May God be gracious to you.
May
God smile with you. May God favor you. And show his encounters to generation to generation. Bless your children. The children of your children. A thousand generations. In Jesus' mighty name. May God keep you. May God bless you. May God increase the glory upon your life. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. And everybody say,
may
the grace and the love of God, fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, with our land Uganda and the land of Israel forever and ever. You are blessed in Jesus' mighty name. You are blessed. I speak now over your life. Your seed will never die, but your seeds will increase.
It's because we don't need you here.
It's the one watering your garden. May your life reflect. May your life become like that well watered garden. Oh, watered by God. The Lord your God. In Jesus' mighty name. Every Saturday we are here. Every Tuesday we are here as intercessors. I need your prayers. This week I'm going to be in Marala. Light up our core. Praise the name of the living God. Let's stay on the altar with God. As we just sit, I'm going to turn for God. Our nation to turn. Nations around us to turn for God. I pray that God will give you the grace to stay on the
oath.
In Jesus' mighty name. We have many conferences going on. I need your prayers. I've been invited in different places. I'll be speaking in different occasions, different events. In this month of June up to July, up to September actually. So I really need the backup of your prayers. I openly doing this because I know we belong together. I talk to you because I know what it means. Praise the name of the living God. So don't I know in your intercessions and your prayers, they will turn out fruitful to you. Because you stand in the covenant to see every time I'm standing ministering to sons of men, the river comes back to you. If there was somebody that would be touched because I'm standing, you will pray when someone, the river will come back to you. That good word will be for you. So I encourage you to stir up your altar. Don't be dismayed. Don't be discouraged. God is not looking for the entire society. No. God is looking for one man, one boy, one woman who is going to connect with him and do experience with you and use you. Praise the Lord. I pray that you are the one that you are going to connect with him. I pray that you are the one who is feeling and using in this season, in this decade, in Jesus' mighty name. I pray that your altar will be stirred up and your cup is going to be filled. May you be the one available for him in this season where he's looking for a man and a woman to partner with. You are not going to backslid, but you will stand and see salvation. I pray for the grace of strength to come upon you. In Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. In Jesus' mighty name.